welcome to another Pyro Gaming video. Destiny is dead. People still play this game? What? All the time, man. Anytime an event ends in Destiny, anytime a DLC has been out for about a month or so, it starts up. People will go watch Destiny videos just to comment on them. Destiny is dead. People still play this game? It doesn't make any sense to me, man. Now, in Destiny's current state, quite a few people could argue that Destiny is in fact dead at the moment. Me personally, there's nothing for me to do in this game that I feel is worth doing. So what I mean by that is the only reason that I have to play this game is because I want to, and right now I don't really want to, because I don't feel like I have a reason to. Now, this is a common thing to happen after a live event ends or a DLC has been out for a little bit of time. But here's the thing. Just because I'm at a point where I don't necessarily feel like I need to play Destiny every day, that doesn't mean that I'm going to go around and dictate to the world that Destiny is dead. Because the truth of the matter is that yesterday and every day prior to yesterday, Destiny averages about 1.2 million active users. Now, for a 2.5-year-old game, 1.2 million active users is pretty fucking ridiculous. That's higher than GTA 5. That's higher than Minecraft on most consoles. That is a ton of people, guys. And considering that this happened yesterday where no event was going on, no new DLC was presented, there was nothing new to do. You're still talking about the same game that we've had since the dawning ended. 1.2 million people. And that's the average per day. Now, when you take all that into consideration, like, you have to be asking yourself, either number one, there's still a lot of people out there that haven't experienced everything this game has to offer. Maybe they're not max light. Maybe they haven't done all the raids. You know, maybe they just got the game and they're starting brand new, you know, at level 3 or 4 or whatever, and they're playing through the story mode. Like, maybe they're completionists and they have to go collect all the ships, all the shaders, all the emblems, all that stuff. Whatever the case may be, Destiny still has a very, very, very dedicated fan base. And to a certain extent, Destiny is the definition of insanity. Now, hear me out. The actual literal definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results. And, I mean, if that doesn't sum up Destiny in a nutshell, I don't know what does. And I say that as a Destiny fan. I love this game. I've never had a game that I've gotten this involved with, and, you know, I've played for 2.5 years, and I still enjoy it. Even though there's not anything for me to do in it currently, I mean, I still love this game. I'll still pop in once a week and do a Nightfall or something with my buddies. But, I mean, I love this game. It's such a game that just sucks you in and makes you feel like this Guardian right here is, you know, something that you care about. Like, I built this, you know? I've put in the playtime. I've fucking found all these weapons. I found all this gear. I've re-rolled it. Like, this is my dude. This is my dude. This is my Titan, man. This is my guy. And I think a lot of people feel like that. I think a lot of people play this game, not necessarily to escape reality, but because this game has a very unique way of making you feel like you're accomplishing something even when you don't accomplish something. You know, with the RNG loot system, you go pick up a legendary engram from killing just a random patrol dreg in the Cosmodrome, and then you go turn it in at the Cryptarch, and you get like a god roll scout rifle or something. Like, it gives you a feeling of accomplishment without actually accomplishing anything. And, I mean, that is fun, you know, but on the other end of the spectrum, you know, you have stuff like the raid, where completing a raid in Destiny, when it actually is relevant, as of right now, the only relevant raid is the Wrath of the Machine. But when Crota was brand new, when Vault of Glass was brand new, and when King's Fall was brand new, if you beat those, man, like, you were a top-tier player. You know, of course, now you can go and just pub stomp them as much as you want, but, you know, at their height, when they were brand new, if you beat those, you were top 5% in the game when they were relevant. And, you know, even Wrath of the Machine, I feel like Wrath of the Machine is probably the easiest raid, aside from Crota, that we've had to date in Destiny. When Crota first came out, it was a pain in the ass. Crota was so glitchy, you didn't know where he was going to go, what he was going to do. You couldn't really do enough damage with the sword to get him down before he enraged and ogres came out. It was difficult. A lot of people like to joke around about Crota being so easy because you could cheese the bridge, you could cheese the Thrallway, you can kind of cheese the Deathsinger, you can kind of cheese Crota himself. But, you know, the fact of the matter is when that was a level 32 raid and you were a level 30, it was hard, period. Like, you died from two acolyte shots, you know, and it was difficult. It required a lot of communication with your teammates. It required a lot of, you know, back and forth. I mean, it was tough. Wrath of the Machine, I feel like, honestly, anybody can do as long as you have a headset and you can talk. And, I mean, that's fine. You know, I guess Destiny, after King's Fall was a very mechanic-based raid. But I guess Destiny kind of needed an easy raid after King's Fall. You know, because King's Fall did take a lot of time. You did have a lot of boss encounters. You did have a lot of mechanics. There was a lot of communication. Honestly, that's probably my favorite raid in this game, is King's Fall. I loved it. But, you know, going back to what I was saying, you know, Destiny has a very unique way of presenting you the same things over and over and over, and we just keep doing them. And I think that Rise of Iron, honestly, was a pretty big mistake on the part of Bungie. You know, with Rise of Iron, we got some super repetitive stuff, like this. You know, just go do patrols every week. Go get your artifact every week. Go do these every week. And, you know, like, all this stuff, it's a weekly reset. So, I mean, if you don't do it 1 week, no big deal. It's going to be there next week. You can do it then. Or the week after that, or the week after that, or whatever. But, you know, it gets to a point where this is just, it's repetitive, man. Like, Destiny is such a repetitive game. And that goes back to what I was saying earlier. It literally is the definition of insanity, doing the same thing over and over, expecting different results. But I've never seen a game that had such a dedicated fan base, you know, a fan base that will defend this game even during its most dry spells, like right now or like this time last year. Apparently January is a tough month for Destiny, and February. But, I mean, Here's the thing, though. If you get bored of Destiny, there are literally millions of games out there that you can go play. So many Destiny fans treat Destiny like a marriage, like they're married to Destiny, like that's the only game that they could ever play. And if they go play something else, if they go turn on Resident Evil 7, they're cheating on Destiny. And it's so bad. It's so bad, guys. I uploaded a Resident Evil 7 video a couple of weeks ago, and the majority of you commented on it like, oh, are you giving up on Destiny? You just throwing Destiny to the side, bro? You're just going to start playing other games now? Unsub. I mean, what is that, man? As a Destiny YouTuber, I can't go play other games? I mean, come on. Don't be ridiculous. This is not the only game in the world. And honestly, if this is the only game that you're playing, then you're going to be the one that gets burnt out on it the quickest. If every single day you come home from school, you come home from work, maybe you don't go to school, you don't go to work, you just wake up in the morning and you turn on Destiny, and you go and grind the living shit out of the same activities every single day, you're going to be the one that gets tired of this game. You're going to be the one that goes and trolls on videos saying, Destiny's dead. People still play this? It's so boring. You need to play other games, guys. I mean, me personally, I bought Resident Evil 7. I think it's a really fun game. I enjoy playing it. I still play Minecraft from time to time. I still bust out GTA 5 from time to time. MLB The Show on PlayStation, I play that quite a bit. I mean, there's so many games. Ghost Recon Wildlands comes out next month. I'm all about that. That looks like a lot of fun to me. So I will definitely be playing some Ghost Recon Wildlands when it comes out. And, you know, when Destiny comes out with the spring update, I mean, I'm going to be right back into this because Destiny is my favorite game. But just because something's your favorite, like let's say that pizza is your favorite food. If you eat pizza every fucking day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, how long is it going to be before you're tired of pizza? If you just keep cramming pizza down your throat, you're going to hate pizza after a while. And that's why the word moderation is very important for video gamers. Honestly. anything that you do over and over and over again is going to make you hate it. Unless, of course, you're talking about winning the lottery. If you win the lottery over and over and over again, you're probably never going to get tired of it. That's the only exception. But anything else, man, it's going to get boring. It's going to get stale. And, you know, Destiny is... it's one of those games that has a lot of replayability, but only if you don't mind doing the same stuff. You know, I mean, you can go in and do the strikes, and Bungie's made... Let me go ahead and say this. Bungie has made an amazing effort since the launch of Destiny to keep this game fresh. They've made it to where you go into a strike and it's not the same stuff. You know, back in year one, I'm sure a lot of you year one players will remember, you would go into Valis to Auric or the Nexus or whatever, and every single enemy would be in the exact same place. Like, there was no randomness to it. It was linear. It was every enemy in the exact same place. You knew that in this room there was going to be 13 fucking Vex and a Hydra. You knew that in this room there was going to be 13 Cabal and a Centurion. Like, it was all very predictable and very boring. Now, you go into any strike, you don't know what you're going to get. You can get a Taken version, you can get a Fallen version, you can get, you know, Vex version. Like, there's so many different ways to play the game now that it's not all the same. And I think that that's great. I think that that was a good move on Bungie's part. You know, just to kind of mix things up. Have a little bit of unpredictability to it. And, you know, you don't know what you're getting until you're actually spawned in. Like, it'll spawn in the Taken version of a strike, and it'll still be Cabal on Valis to Auric, right? Like, it's neat. I like that. I like that, you know, there is an element of randomness to it. Now, for the raids... you know, there's a lot of talk about Bungie bringing back the old raids, bringing King's Fall, Crota, and Vault of Glass up to year 3 light levels. And to be perfectly honest with you, I'm kind of 50-50 on whether or not I think that that's going to be a thing. On one hand, if they do it, that gives you, you know, some more opportunities to earn some gear, which is always good. It gives you more activities to play. One of my biggest problems in Destiny right now is that there's so many ways to get to 400, but there's only so many activities you can do that are max light. I think that being light level 400 or max light level has pretty much lost all of its meaning since Rise of Iron. There's too many different ways to get to it, and you don't have to do any in-game activities to achieve it. For example, on PlayStation, in about 2 total days playtime, I was able to hit 400 on all 3 of my characters without doing the raid. And on one hand, that's good. On the other hand, that's kind of shitty. Like, I kind of prefer the old way. Like, you had to go beat Crota to get max light level. You had to go and get Etheric Light from the Prison of Elders to hit max light level. Like, you have to go do the in-game activities. I kind of miss that way, honestly. Like, still have your Iron Banner comes around. Like, Iron Banner can give you max light gear or whatever. But as far as actual in-game stuff, Nightfall, Shaxx Bounty, Raid, Prison of Elders. I think that's what it should be. And I know a lot of people are going to disagree with me on that. But if you're a year one player, then you understand the struggle. And that struggle, it was a good struggle to have. Because it made you want to do more activities in Destiny. It made you want to be a better player. It made you want to do all this stuff. Now it's, oh, well, I can hit 400 from just going and doing a couple of simple Zavala bounties and 320 strikes, going and doing some Archon's Forge, and going and playing a few Crucible matches. And that's depressing, man. It really is. Like, it's way too easy to get to max light. And, you know, going back to what I was saying about bringing the new raids forward, like, on one hand, it would be great to have those extra paths to get max light. But on the other hand, when you think about the logistics of Bungie actually bringing those raids back, you bring back Fatebringer, nobody gives a shit about Imago Loop. You bring back Black Hammer, nobody gives a shit about Black Spindle. You bring back Vision of Confluence, nobody gives a shit about Zalo Supercell. You know, like, number one, Bungie said they don't want elemental primaries. Zalo Supercell is the only current primary in the game that has an elemental burn. You bring back the old raids. You have Word of Crota that does void damage. You have Fatebringer that does arc. You have Vision of Confluence that does solar. You have Fangavir Ute that does arc. Bungie would have to retract on everything that they wanted to do in order to bring those back. And not only that, you know, Treads Upon Stars is a knockoff of Vision of Confluence. You bring back Vision of Confluence, which was honestly one of the best scout rifles in this game. Treads Upon Stars doesn't matter anymore. You bring back Fatebringer, Imago Loop doesn't matter anymore. I don't see Bungie just saying, hey, these are trash. Don't worry about these. Go do the raid and get these. Number two, there's a lot of ways to cheese those raids. The old raids. Crota and Vault of Glass, there's so many ways to cheese them. And I think that if you brought them up to max light, people would still be able to solo Crota fairly easily. And I don't think that that's something that Bungie wants to do. I think that they would have to change the raids. I think that they would have to change some of the mechanics. I think that they would have to pretty much rebuild the raids. And I don't see them putting in that much time and effort into rebuilding old content this late in Destiny's life cycle, just so people can have a little bit more to do before Destiny 2 comes out. And that brings me to my next point, guys. We don't know when Destiny 2 is coming out. Destiny 2 was originally rumored to come out September of last year. That was the original plan. We haven't heard anything from Bungie about it. Every single YouTube video that you watch that says Destiny 2 will come out this time, it's total clickbait bullshit. Nobody knows. Now, Bungie had their, or Activision, rather, is about to have their, you know, like, yearly conference call where they say what's going on and all that stuff. Don't expect a lot of information from that, guys. Until Bungie themselves says, Destiny 2 is a thing, and this is when we are expecting to release it, don't buy into any of the clickbait bullshit, because that is exactly what it is clickbait bullshit. And that's exactly why you have not seen a video like that on my channel. It's all speculation. It's all just people's theories. None of it is fact. When we have an actual, factual, 100% legitimate from Bungie release date for Destiny 2, that is when you will see that video on this channel. Not until then. I might do a video of what I would expect to see in Destiny 2, or what I would like to see in Destiny 2, but even that, I feel like it's too clickbait. I don't even want to do that. But let's say, hypothetically, that Destiny 2 releases in September of this year. What you have is a game right now, this game, Destiny 1, that I'm in right now, a game that is on its last leg, a game that is on its dying breath, and a game that, quite frankly, Bungie probably doesn't care a whole lot about anymore. If you're about to have a major release, and you're a game developer, you're not going to put all your eggs in the old game's basket. You're going to put all your effort, all your manpower, all your resources into making the new game better. So, that being said, we have a spring update slash April update scheduled for Destiny 1. And I would not be surprised if that is the last update that we get for this game before Destiny 2. There's going to be a dry spell in Destiny 1 that is bigger than what we currently have. And that's going to be the weeks and months leading up to Destiny 2. Now, the flip side of that, let's say that Destiny 2, for whatever reason, gets delayed. They can't get it out this September. Say it comes out early next year, like around this time next year. Then we'll probably get another DLC pack. Something similar to Rise of Iron, for example. Just because that's 6 to 8 months, and I mean, you can't go that long without new content. You just can't. They learned that after The Taken King was released, and there was that huge stretch between The Taken King and the April update. So many people left this game. So many people were pissed. And I think Bungie learned their lesson pretty quickly on that. But what you have to keep in mind is, even if we do have a definitive release date for Destiny 2, just having that knowledge isn't going to bring people back to Destiny 1. So I'm going to try to bring all of this full circle. I know that this has been a long rant. There was a lot that I wanted to say on this topic. But just to bring it all full circle, when Destiny 2 is announced, that is not going to make anybody want to play Destiny 1. That's not going to change the content that we have. That's not going to change the content that's available. That's not going to change how we play Destiny 1. Unless, of course, there's a big DLC that ties into the story of Destiny 2, then Destiny 1 is what it is. And I don't see them changing this game up a whole lot between now and then. So that being said, if you are a diehard Destiny fan, you are not married to this game. This is not the only game that you are allowed to play. You are not breaking any rules by going and playing other games. When you bought Destiny, you did not sign a contract saying Destiny is the only game that I will play for the duration of this game's lifespan. Go play other games, guys. Go enjoy yourself. Go outside. Go play baseball, man. That's what I used to do. When I got tired of a video game, I would fucking go play baseball, go ride four-wheelers, go ride dirt bikes. I mean, just do something. Don't ruin this game for yourself for no reason other than you just want to play it. I mean, I cannot stress that enough, guys. There's been so many games that I absolutely loved, you know, prior to Destiny that I just played so much that I can't even turn them on now because I know every little detail about it. I have every little piece of gear that you could possibly get in the game. And, you know, I'm kind of getting to that point in Destiny. And I don't want to get to that point in Destiny because I do truly love this game. I think it is a fantastic game. I think it's a great idea. I bought this game the day it came out in September of 2014. And I'm 2.5 years into this shit, man. I've spent so much time in this game. I think my total play time is somewhere around 70 days, you know, at 24 hours a day. I mean, I've put a lot of time and effort into this game, and I've beaten everything that this game has to offer. I've gone to the lighthouse. I've beaten all the raids. You know, I've done really well on Iron Banner. I've gone on like some epic Crucible kill streaks. I mean, there's nothing left for me to accomplish in this game. And until they add something new for me to accomplish, I probably won't play this game very much. Now, that being said, as a Destiny YouTuber, I made a commitment to myself and to you, my subscribers, all 40,000 of you, to upload Destiny content. And I will continue to do that, even if I'm not playing the game regularly. I know that there's quite a few of you out there that really appreciate the content that I put out, that, you know, really get good use out of the content that I put out, and I'm not going to let you down. I'm going to keep putting content out. I'm going to keep making videos of hopefully, you know, unique things. I know that's kind of hard to do in Destiny. Somebody figured out that you can glitch into the Abomination heist, and every fucking Destiny YouTuber known to man had to make a video about it, except Pyro, because Pyro doesn't jump on the bandwagon. I personally don't see why you would ever need to glitch into the Abomination heist and kill him without him doing any damage to you. He's not a hard boss to beat. But, you know, so many Destiny YouTubers, like, somebody will make a video and everybody's just jumping on that bandwagon. Like, oh, that guy got a lot of views with that video. Let me make the same thing. Maybe I'll get a lot of views. I'm not like that. All right, I'm going to try my best to make original content that nobody else is making. I want to give you a reason to subscribe to my channel instead of going and subscribing to another channel that's doing the exact same thing, but you just prefer their voice over mine. I want to give you a reason to come to my channel and look through my videos and say, that looks interesting. I haven't seen that before. I'm going to watch this video. And it's a challenge, man. It really and truly is. But, I mean, if you want to be a Destiny YouTuber, or any kind of YouTuber, you have to make original content. You have to do stuff on your own. You have to be your own person. Because a lot of times, it's going to come down to not so much the content that you provide, but how you provide it. And that's something that I want to make as an easy decision to you guys. I want to have my own opinions. I want to have, you know, my own ideas. I don't want to be somebody else. And actually, I don't even really watch other Destiny YouTubers anymore because I'll watch a video on somebody doing a glitch or something like that, and I'll be like, man, that's a really cool glitch. I really want to make a video about that. But then I start second-guessing myself. But, you know, they already did it. Other people are already doing it, so maybe I shouldn't do it. So I don't even watch the current videos that other Destiny YouTubers are making, because I don't want to be, I guess, tempted to copy them. I want to be my own dude. I want to be Pyro. I don't want to be somebody else, you know? But I think that's it, guys. I think that's all I have to rant about in this video. I'm going to leave you with this. I'm going to go ahead and wrap up the commentary here, but I want to leave you with one thing. Whether you love Destiny or whether you hate Destiny, don't be influenced by other people. If you truly love Destiny, don't read a comment that says, Destiny's dead, why are you playing this, you fucking scrub, you fucking noob, blah, 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 hashtag YOLO. Don't let that influence you. If you truly love this game, if you truly love the grind, don't let anybody tell you otherwise. Including me. I know I've said a lot in this video, you shouldn't just go play it for the sake of playing it, but if that's what makes you happy, man, go do it. You know, on the flip side of that, if you think Destiny's dead, if you don't want to play Destiny anymore, you're bored of it, you're tired of it, take a break, man. Go play something else. Like, don't hesitate. Don't just keep playing this game, you know, because your friends are playing it. Don't keep playing this game because other people are saying that it's still good. You know, don't come back into this game just to do a fucking Hive Abomination Strike glitch that is completely pointless. Just be your own person. That's the moral of this video, man. Just be your own person, make your own decisions, and enjoy life. Don't worry about enjoying a game. Enjoy life, man. But anyway, guys, that is going to wrap this video up. I ended up talking for a lot longer than I intended to, so I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. If you enjoyed it, click like. If you're new to the channel, click subscribe. And if you're already subscribed, I fucking love you. Thank you for watching, and thank you so much for 40,000 subscribers. Take care, guys.